Okay, so let's check in on QAnon and what people think about it. And this matters. We're gonna give you the results of a study of what different demographic groups think about the absolutely insane theories of these QAnon people. But bear in mind, already in the 2022 congressional cycle, there are 19 declared QAnon candidates for office. Isn't that fun? There were way more in 2020, and there's a lot of time. We'll probably break records. And this is not like delving deep into their forum posts to try to find some indication. No, they're just putting hashtag when we go one, we go all in their comments and stuff like that. It is open QAnon stuff. Well, what country are they running in? What will the American people think? Well, at large, depending on how you word it, and it's pretty conspiratorial stuff. They're not trying to trick people into answering this. Like if you ask people, the government, media, and financial worlds in the US are controlled by a group of Satan worshiping pedophiles who run a global child sex trafficking operation. One of the core elements of the QAnon thing. 15% of all Americans are like, yeah, no, that's true. That's a thing that's true. 23% of Republicans, hell, 8% of Democrats believe that at large. And you can get different numbers if you word it differently, like there is a storm coming soon that will sweep away the elites in power and restore the rightful leaders, that sort of nonsense. 28% of Republicans believe that. Fully 1 in 5 of all Americans believe, oh, you know, everybody that I don't like in politics and entertainment, they're gonna be swept away. You're gonna have no more Biden, no more Chrissy Teigen. It's all coming up me, thanks to the storm that's coming. And we've got a lot more that's gonna break this down. Including that last bit on there about violence. But Dr. Rashad, what do you think about this? 20-25%, something like that, thinking that this is true.
Yeah, and that number is going to increase. And here's the problem with indoctrination. Indoctrination is exactly what you're reading. These individuals have been told a lie. But it's not just the lie. Indoctrination never works when you just do it one time. Indoctrination works by repetition. So how was repetition used? Twitter, Facebook, whatever. The 25 news cycle of Fox News. This repetition allows an individual to consume all of their information from one source. Now it looks like different platforms, but it's one source. It's one message. And they have now started to believe the message. It's not a coincidence that last year, the number of QAnon conspiracy theorists was lower than it is this year. It means that the indoctrination has continued and more people are believing the madness. And we have seen it now on a mass scale. And at some point in the future, this is gonna be a great case study for mass psychology.
Yeah, well, and in the meantime, what's gonna happen as a result of these beliefs? Because, you know, like on some level, I think simply believing that like Satanists are in charge everywhere is problem enough. But what could that actually produce? Well, bad stuff. Because when you ask the American people, because things have gotten so far off track, true American patriots may have to resort to violence in order to save our country. 15% of all Americans are like, yes, that is true. 28% of all Republicans believe that it might be true. Some independents and even 7% of Democrats believe violence may be necessary because things have gotten off track. Now, they don't necessarily believe that they've gotten off track because of the global cabal of Satanists or whatever. But close to 1 in 3 of all Republicans believe, maybe not me, maybe I won't do it, but I don't know, somebody might need to use violence. And I guarantee that's an underestimate. If it, I mean, first of all, we don't have to say if it happened, they tried it on the 6th, and you can already see that the majority of Republicans are perfectly fine with it. They may not storm the barricades, but they're totally cool with those who do. And you know, a few people died, they didn't kill any politicians. It's all speculation as to what Republicans would think if they had. But I personally don't think that if they had literally managed to get Mike Pence to those gallows and had hung him there, I don't think Tucker Carlson would disavow everything that he's been saying and turn over a new leaf. I don't think that most Republicans would be like, oh my God, we've gone too far. All this Trump stuff, this QAnon, we really do need to turn a new direction. I don't think so. I think that their ability to forgive and apologize for literally anything, the worst violent excesses, I think we have not even begun to reach the limits of that.
Yeah, and this is what happens when you get your news from Alex Jones. You create these individuals. I always question the idea of what's happening now in America being the absolute worst thing that has ever happened. Because you have a lot of Republicans who say that the country has been being taken away, that the morality of the country is falling. And then they'll cite things like the LGBTQ community as a way that morality is somehow questionable in the United States of America or somehow falling apart. Did they forget that they used to own people? And they could own those people, kill them, rape them, beat them, molest them without repercussion from the government. I would say that's actually the darkest history in the United States of America. And if you don't believe that that was the darkest hour of this country, everything you say is bull to me.
You know, I don't know why I've never put those two things together. And like obviously QAnon, it like is, you know, national thing, but it's more common in more conservative areas. Mm-hmm. Like they deny that that was bad at all.
Right.
That when there was a political cable, as Marjorie Greene would say, of people human trafficking, sex trafficking, breaking up families, selling people, they don't like care about that at all.
No.
But they don't talk about it. Fictional version really bothers them right now.
Mm-hmm. They do not talk about it in that context. Point. But slavery was also child sex trafficking. Slavery was also child molestation. And they don't, they somehow forget, or they willfully forget the darkness of this country, the real darkness of the country.
Yeah, you're 100% right.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.